Hi, it's Leila here. So today we're going to cover 10 tips and techniques to enhance your Power BI reports. We're going to cover a wide range. There's going to be formatting tips, organizing tips, and productivity tips. I'm curious if you've used any of these, so let me know in the comments as you're watching. Now let's get started. Tip number one, conditional format your charts. You can add conditional formatting to your charts. So here I'm showing the growth rate to previous year. I have negative and positive values here. I want the negative values to have a different color to the positive ones. To do that, select a chart, go to Format Options, down here, select Data Colors, and then click on this effects icon. Here you can decide how you want to conditionally format your chart. I'm going to select Rules. The field name is fine. Now we can decide on our logic. So I want negative values to be in red. So if the value is less than zero, it should have a red color. Let's go with this one. Add a new rule for positive values. If it's greater than or equal to zero, not percent, but the number, and less than, we just have to remove this. So it defaults to max, or you can change this to 100%. Then we want another color. I'm going to go with a green color. Let's just go with this one. Click on OK, and the conditional formatting is automatically applied to your chart. If I change my selection to 2020, it pulls through as well. Tip number two, aligning objects. When you're laying out your dashboard, it's important to properly align your objects. Now you can do that manually if you click on a visual and then you drag it. You get some help from these dotted red lines. But if you have a lot of objects, this is going to be a headache to do manually. What you want to do is automatically align these. First thing you need to do is select your objects. I'm going to select them like this. Go to Format, Align. Let's align these to the top. And if you want them to be distributed properly, go back to Align and select Distribute Horizontally. Let's align these in a different way. So you can also multi-select by holding down Control and selecting each object. Go back to Format, Align, align to the left. And now for these ones, let's distribute these vertically. With the objects selected, you can also move them as one and then place them wherever you need to on your dashboard. Next tip, organize your measures. If you have a lot of different measures and you want to organize them to a separate measures table, this is what you can do. Click on Enter Data to create a dummy table. You can give this table the name that you want your measures table to be called. I'll call mine KPI and then click on Load. We're going to see the table added here. It just has a single column right now. But let's say under data, I already have some measures that I want to move to this KPI table. Let's start with this one first. When I select this, I can see Measure Tools pop up here, and the home table is currently data because this is where it's sitting in. I'm going to change that to the new KPI table. Now I have my first measure added to this, but I want my measures table to be on top here, right? All I need to do is remove this column here. I'm just going to right mouse click and hide it from the model. And immediately my KPI table gets a different icon set and it jumps on top. This now is a dedicated measures table. I can move all the other measures to this table, but I don't want to go to each single measure and do this manually. Instead, I want to do it all at once. To do that, go to Relationships, click on Data, and there are more options here. Select the measures. This is going to automatically select all the measures in this table. Now from the Properties menu here, adjust the home table to be the new KPI table. This way, all my measures automatically shifted to my measures table. Tip number four, organize your measures into different folders. In case you have a lot of measures, you can put them in separate folders. To do that, go to the model side and select the measures you want to put in a folder. So you can multi-select, just hold down Control. In this case, I'm going to select the quantity measures and create a display folder here. I'll want them inside a folder called quantity. That's automatically going to organize them in this folder. You can repeat for other measures. I'm just going to select these and put these in the sales folder. Now, when I jump to my reporting tab here, we can see my measures are organized accordingly. Tip number 5, pimp up your dashboard with custom backgrounds. So here I've set up this dashboard, but I want it to stand out more. I want it to look nicer. I can use a custom image background for it. One way to do this is set it up in PowerPoint. So here I have a PowerPoint slide and I've added all of these different objects to the slide. Then save this as a PNG. So you can do that by going to File, Save As, or Save a Copy in this case. From this dropdown, select PNG. Once you have it saved as a PNG, go back to your dashboard, click in an empty area just to make sure no object is selected, then go to the Format options. Down here, you're going to see Page Background. You can decide on a color for your background, right? So if you didn't want to use an image, you can select a color and turn transparency off so you can see that color. In this case, I want to add an image, so I'm going to click on Add Image. Select the PNG, mine is called this, click on Open, and it's going to bring it to the background, but you can't see it if transparency is on, so we are going to turn transparency off. And now we can see our dashboard already looks a lot fancier. And down here, you also have some options for fitting the image. I'll go and select Fit. You can then adjust the other visuals that you have. So for example, for the title here, I don't want it to have that white background. So I'm going to select it and turn off the background. And then I want the text to be white. So let's just select this and adjust the font color to white. Okay, so here you're free to design any type of background you want for your dashboards. Next tip, customize your tooltips. In Power BI, whenever you hover over any of these visuals, you get this default tooltip text. You can customize that. If I select this one, for example, and scroll down here, I can see tooltips, and I can add additional fields to this that I don't have in this visual. So in this case, I'm going to grab total quantity and add it to tooltips. Now, whenever I hover over this, I get total sales, and I also get total quantity. Now, in addition to just adding tooltips here, you can create separate tooltip pages and show whatever visual or text or graphic that you want to show. To do that, first you need to add a new page. I'll just call it My Tips. Then go to Format here, under Page Information, change this to Tooltip. So turn this on for Tooltip. Scroll down for Page Size, change this as well to Tooltip. Page alignment, I'm just going to update this and put it in the middle. Now it's up to you, whatever you want to add to this tooltip, go ahead and do it. One thing I want to do is insert a text box and type in top 5 customer groups, because let's say that's what I want to show in my tooltip. I'm going to make this bold and center it. I also want to add a table that shows the customer groups. So I'm going to find them under Master Customer Data. That's right here. And then add in total sales. Let's place a check mark here. Now I might have a lot of groups, so I want to restrict this to the top 5. Let's add a filter for this visual. Click on this dropdown and change this to top N. I want to see the top 5 based on total sales. I'm just going to drag and drop this here. Now let's apply the filter, and I have top 5 customer groups here. Let's just give this more breathing space and adjust the sort order. So now that we have our tooltip page in place, let's go back to our visual here and use that. Collapse the filters, select the visual, go to Format options, under Tooltip, we're going to change the type from default to a report page. Now, the only tooltip page I have is the one I called My Tips, so we're going to go with that. Now, check this out. Whenever I hover over any of these, I get to see the top 5 customer groups, and they're going to be different depending on my selection. Tip number 7, add a page navigator to your dashboard. This is like creating an automatic table of contents for your dashboard. Power BI recently got an update that allows you to do that automatically. Just go to Insert, Buttons, all the way on the bottom, you're going to see Navigator, select Page Navigator. This automatically adds buttons for your pages. You have some options to adjust this. For example, under pages, you can decide if you want to show or hide hidden pages, if you want to show tooltip pages or hide them. If I select show, we're going to see my tooltip page. If I hide it, it's automatically going to disappear. If you rename tabs or add new tabs, this automatically gets adjusted. You can change the shape as you need. Default is rectangle, but you can go with oval, arrow, heart, and so on. If you want to jump to a specific page on the desktop, you have to hold down Control and then select the button. On the web, you just have to click on a button. Next tip, create a back button. So this tip is related to the previous tip. Remember, we created a page navigator where we can jump to different pages. Now it would be nice to have a way to go back. All you have to do is go to Insert, Buttons, and select Back. This is going to automatically insert a back button for you. You can position this where you want. Now, whenever you select it, so remember on desktop, I have to use Control Click. I'm going to go back to the main page. Next tip is to lock objects. Once you've set up your dashboard and you're happy with the layout, you want to make sure that no one unintentionally goes in and moves these different objects around. You want to lock them in place. To do that, press Ctrl A to select all the objects, go to View, and place a check mark for Lock Objects. Now everything is locked into place. No one can unintentionally move these around. Tip number 10, save your reports as PDF. You can create a PDF file out of all your reports that you have on your dashboard. All you need to do, go to File, Export, and Export to PDF. This is going to go through each tab, so it might take some time, but once it's done, it's going to generate one PDF document for you.
A few moments later.
And this is our PDF document. So it's going to put it in a temporary folder, but you can click on Save As and save it in the folder that you want. Okay, so those are my tips for now. Please share any cool tips of your own in the comments below as well. I'm really looking forward to reading those. Thank you for watching, thank you for being here, and I'm going to see you in the next video.